Please start, yeah.
Very good evening to the respected director management, to the eminent guest of the day, to my respected teachers and my dear friends. Today we have among us one of the esteemed figurehead, Mr. Amrit Tyagi, alumnus of PGTM 2007-9 batch, to share his experience with management students under this theme towards excellence, a journey with ITS achievers. But before we begin with, I would like to take the onus of introducing sir to you all. He is currently working as regional head, not telco and SARC at Radware Limited, and successfully planned and executed market development initiatives at the highly competitive national and international level to deliver customer-focused solutions. He has experience in strategic account management, large enterprise, corporate sales, handling partner and ecosystem, techno-commercial negotiations, and customer service in telecom and cybersecurity businesses. Core competence in corporate and enterprise sales, strategic and key account management, channel business development. He also handles partners and distributors, client servicing, relationship management, and competition handling. He also expertises in providing technical solutions, presentations, and managing service operations and resolving service-related critical issues. He's an out-of-the-box thinker with a proven track record of achieving targets, streamlining workflow, and creating a teamwork environment to enhance productivity. So I, Pranav Kumar, on behalf of the PGTM Batch 2022, and also on my personal behalf, welcome you, sir, to this virtual alumni session put up by ITS Ghaziabad. Your presence today has delighted us truly. So I would now request our Director Management, ma'am, to enhance us with some glorious words and welcome our guest of honor. Over to you, ma'am.
Yes, thank you, Pranav. Welcome, Amrit, to the ITS again, after almost 11 years down the line, and yes, you are coming back to Alma Mater on this virtual forum.
Thank you, ma'am.
It is always really very pleasant feeling, when we see our alumnus back to the campus. So I was listening to your profile. It is great when we see our students flying with high colors and walking into the corporate corridor and with the brand, Telco, no doubt. I think we are really proud of these type of companies. And no doubt, with whatever experience you have earned in last 11 years when you left the campus, and you must have taken some of the preachings from the campus and actually utilized them in the corporate world, and you people are the brand ambassadors finally. So whatever the institute is today, no doubt alumni is the very strongest pillar of any campus. So we are proud with the alumni like you, and we really extend you a warm welcome on this wonderful afternoon. I'm sure that you're going to share with the students your campus experience along with your first corporate break, and how you fared, how skilling, reskilling, and honing the contemporary issues is very important today. And there are certain myths in the minds of the students, especially when they actually dream for a great job with the red carpet welcome in a corporate. And I think these myths get burst when you actually join a company. So I'm sure that when they actually listen from horse's mouth and youngsters like you, they feel that teachers always talk like this because it is our habit to advise them, and they might be tired of our advices. So this specially, chartered alumni sessions are, we actually wanted to listen and make students understand that once upon a time, maybe a few years back, our alumni used to share the same benches in the same classroom, and look where they are today. And yes, with the galaxy of alumni, what we are having, we started this series from Monday, and we are going to have a week-long activity. And we really are proud with our ITS achievers. You have actually proven the mettle in a corporate. So ITS tag is definitely, you are carrying high. So I think students are more interested in listening to you. They listen to me always. So, Amrit, we welcome you once again on behalf of the entire faculty and the students. Management is also always very proud of alumni. And we would love to listen from you, how you fared, and some of the tips. I request students that these are very prestigious series. Listen to the past out students very carefully, because they also used to sail in the same boat where you are today. And how to balance the life you will get great tips from them. And don't feel hesitate to ask the questions. I know there are plenty of questions coming to your mind. And if you want to actually achieve those dreams, you will have to work hard towards it. Dreaming, everybody has got a right to dream. And dreaming small is crying always. So always dream high. But only dreaming high is of no use. You have to actually work towards achievement of those dreams and fulfilling those dreams. That is very important. So ask as many as questions possible. Okay, and this should be an interactive session rather than a monologue. It has to be dialogue. I understand on virtual it becomes a problem. But let us make it more interesting. You can type your questions on the chat box and our student representative will read them. So Amrut, with this, I hand over the dais to you and welcome you again.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much. Yeah, please, sir. Please, sir.
Just to brief, ma'am, that today we have one more alumnus with us, Saurabh Singh Rajput.
Okay.
And he turned to a vector.
Yeah, yeah. He has joined already.
He has joined. He is there.
Great. I would like to see him. Where is he? I am not able to see him.
Saurabh Singh is there. So let me just pin it.
Here am I. Probably because of the audio, the moment I start speaking, then only I am visible.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for having me here.
I've done it.
So welcome to you also. Whatever I said is for both of you. Huh? So it doesn't matter where you are, but only thing is to pursue your passion. And if acting is your passion, I think it is very fascinating, you know. And if you do not follow your passion, you are killing your dreams. Yeah. I always believe in pursuing your dreams. And again, you remember those three idiots. Otherwise, you will not become a good photographer. So our new education policy is actually in that direction. If anybody want to become actor, we have to provide the platform in the campus itself.
Absolutely.
So I think here onwards, we are going to add these subjects also. Let the student have a passion and choice. You can have one of the subject with whatever credits we can give. But then I think we will come actually, whatever is the hidden talent of the student. Yes, academics is important. But another side of a coin is your talent is again more important. So I'm really proud of you that you are pursuing your passion. And you must have made, you know, some, you know, mark in the area. And we are really proud to have an alumni like you. So welcome to you, Saurabh Singh, once again.
And
I'm sure that students will really be enjoying your session. Okay, so Amrut and Saurabh, we are proud of you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much.
I hope students will enjoy. Amrut, over to you.
Yeah, sure. Thank you, Dee. Thank you very much. Thank you, ma'am, for this wonderful welcome. And thanks, Pranav, for such a great introduction. Tumhari baatein sunke lag raha tha, itna sab kuch karta hu. Honestly, karta nahi hu itna sab kuch. It was a lengthy description that what I do currently. So, well, honestly speaking, as ma'am said that, yes, alumni is one of the biggest pillar for our institute. My thought process is little different that for us, institute is one of the pillar, actually what we carry throughout our life. Because wherever we go, whosoever people we meet, within India, outside India, or wherever we go, actually, we used to speak about our institution, that where we have came from where we studied, right? What all our colleagues are doing. So this is the one of the biggest thing what we always carry, and we always want ITS to be at that stage where we can say it proudly what we are currently doing it, and we are saying it very, very proudly that we are a pass out of ITS. This is what it is. Well, coming back to my professional career, if I talk about my current organization, yes, Radware is a cybersecurity company where I'm currently working. And it is my passion from the day one when I started studying in schools. When I started studying, not means that in a first class when I took admission, it is somewhere around 8th to 10th class when I actually reached in those classes. I am very much inclined towards IT kind of things since day one. And this is where actually I reached. Why I'm sharing you this particular thing? Because when you are clear from the day one that in which industry you want to get an entry. So you work towards that. And that's how I reached in Radware. So currently I'm handling 6 different countries along with some African countries and this Asian countries. Our company is based out of Israel, right? So I frequently visit there as well. And we are taking care of one of the biggest customers in India and outside India as well. So this is what we are doing. So, well, if I talk about that, what exposure I got from ITS, it was a great great exposure through this seminars, through this industrial exposure. There were so many people, those who used to visit at that point in time. I am actually afraid to say this, that you guys are little on a dicey thing and little on the dicey place, that we are actually, you didn't got that kind of exposure because of this pandemic situation throughout this year. That was a great deficit, actually, I can see, which you may face in future also. But having said that, we were lucky enough that we got that kind of exposure at that point in time, that we got to interact with many people and we got to know about industry, that where it is heading towards, what we can choose out of, because there are so many industries out in the field. You can work for FMCG, you can work for liquor industry, you can work for media, you can work for automotive, you can work for security, you can work for IT, ITS. There are so many industries. So my biggest suggestion is that everyone whosoever is doing PGTM or any professional course and want to pursue their career, they have to be very clear that which industry is most fascinating for them. That is the biggest thing. Because only then you will get to learn about those industries. As I'm telling you that I was very, very interested towards IT. So I want to share my this experience with you, that where it got started. So when I passed out from 12th, I joined GNIIT. I don't know that if you have heard about that or not. There is an institute which is called NIIT Technologies. It used to offer programs like this Diploma in Information Technology, and there was a course with the name GNIIT, which was equivalent to MCA. So I joined that because I was very fascinating towards this IT and ITS things. Then when I started actually doing programming, I learned so many things. I learned Java, J2SE, J2ME. I worked on SQL. I worked on so much of technical things, but over a period of time, it was a course of 3 years. I got to learn that this is not my cup of tea because it was purely on this development side. So what I used to do that at that point in time, we used to sit in the morning on the desktop and we used to start coding. And till end of the day, we have to do the same job, that monotonous job. Every morning you sit on a desktop, start doing coding. And since evening, you will do the same thing. That was not my cup of tea. So I decided to drop down that particular course. I reduced that course from 3 years to 1 year. I convinced my parent. And I converted my program in a this Diploma in Information Technology only. So I completed DIT with a healthy marks, healthy this report card. And finally, I started pursuing my graduation, which is again BSc IT. So in BSc also, I took IT because again, it is my cup of tea because I want to. I am of both of both. I got to MC as in program, and I can actually get some different colleges. Just a minute, yeah, please. Yeah, sorry, other institute. But having said that, as I told you that I was very clear that I was not meant for coding. I can't sit on a single different place. I want to explore world. I want to actually see different things and different industries. So I decided from that day that yes, I have to get into sales. And it was a very clear agenda in my mind since my graduation time. I'm talking about my UG time, this undergraduate time. So in PGTM, that's why I joined PGTM, that gave me that kind of exposure where actually I'm pursuing my career today. And in PGTM also, I have took those subjects which is completely relevant to my industry. I took marketing as a major and IT as a minor. Again, IT I took. So during the course of my PGTM, I got so much of exposure during seminars, during this industrial exposure, meeting with different people, the people, those who are coming there for guest lecture, I used to interact with them, used to understand with them that how this industry moves, the companies which are doing always learning things, and I was very, very clear that I have to get an entry only and only into an IT company. So this is where actually I started for. Then from the institute, I was lucky enough, I got a DE to with a company named Madura Quotes, which is the world's largest thread manufacturing in each and every organization. And she was a great mentor since then. including Vajpayee sir, Dhruv sir, definitely everyone is there. But I was getting too much of this insight thing from Durba ma'am always. So she has given me a chance to sit in our this interview for this Madhura Courts. And then I started working there. But as I told you that I was very much fascinated towards this IT industry. So I was really not actually inclined towards that I need to pursue my career within the same organization or not. And I was thinking that after 1 year or 2 years, definitely when I get experience, I will definitely switch over to any of the IT company. But luckily, an incident happened. I met with an accident and my arm got broken. So I got a leave for two months almost, right? And that was a turning point of my life when I met with an accident, because then I actually took off from the company that I'm not able to drive any car or bike and I can't able to go out in the field. So there is no point of coming to office because I joined in sales, right? And sales is all about meeting people, right? Going out in the field, meet with different people and crack the deals for the company, right? This is where I started again for the interview process. And I approached so many people and then I luckily got a chance to work in Tulip Telecom in Uttarakhand. I joined that company in Chandigarh, which was the regional office for North, rest of North, and I started working for complete state. I was given a responsibility of complete SME market, SMB market, BFSI market in Dehradun, and I started working there and taking care of whole state. Then I actually learned so many new things over there, that what is bandwidth, what is network, what is NLD, what is ILD. There are so many technical things, this international long distance, MPLS, ILL. There are so many different things which were there at that point in time, and it was a quite new thing for me because coming out from this PGDM program, definitely it was completely all about management. But learning technology is again a challenge for me because we have to be updated for each and everything if you want to be relevant in industry for your life. So we have to keep on learning new and new things. So this is what I did in Tulip. I learned the complete network, that how it runs, how it actually behaves, how it helps industries to achieve their KRIs, their basically the operational activities, what we can say, right? So I have learned the entire thing, and definitely there I was successful to sell these kind of services to the organizations which is called SME or the large enterprises also. And I cracked some of the biggest deals with government also. In the initial days of my career, I did presentation to General Khanduri, who was the chief minister of that state at that point in time, and I cracked. Actually, it was an organization where I was working in Dehradun and for growth, and always for growth, that I have to achieve certain kind of project. Actually, I was taking care of different countries and that, and I be industry. So I started changing job. Then I got a different kind of exposure because Tulip Telecom was, I'm not saying that was not a good organization. It was a wonderful organization. But having said that, every company have a set product of line. So Tulip Telecom was very much limited to the network only. But when we talk about Airtel, it has a various product line. Like it has mobility product, it has dongle, it has PRIs, it has network, it has data center services, it has VSAT, it has teleport, it has so many different things. And this is what actually I got to learn in Airtel. Right. So I joined Airtel. I started working for that company. And again, I actually learned so many different things. And I'm always a very, very keen learner. And I always want to learn new and new things. That's how actually you be relevant in industry. Because when you used to sit with CXO people, right? So you have to have those kind of information where you can behave as a consultant, not a sales guy. Believe me, nowadays, this industry is changing in such a paradigm shift that people want to interact with only those people, those who have enough knowledge and they can behave as a consultant, especially in IT, ITS, where we are working. We can't take our product in a bouquet that, yes, boss, we have this in different product. You please choose that what you want and you can straight away go ahead with that product. We have to make them understand that how their infrastructure runs, right? What is their baseline infrastructure? What is their overlay infrastructure? How they achieve their KRAs? How they achieve their the certain things, the kind of milestone, what they have prepared for this 1 year, 3 year, 5 year, all a long-term goal, right? And we have to talk in that sense, which is relevant for those CXO people. Only then we will be able to sell our product. This is the hardcore truth, right? And for that particular thing, we have to learn and study too much. Because you know, you have to know about entire product line. Even if you are working with, as I'm giving you my example, that I'm working with Radware and we are working in a cybersecurity company, doesn't mean that we are covering all 100 product, right? 100 different also. We have to have information about those products also, that what they do and what we do and how we are relevant and fitting those products and fit in ourselves well, where we can be valued by those companies and those CX people. Only then they will buy your comments and they will buy your this points, whatever you made. That 1 year actually I used to switch. Definitely I used to spend almost 2 to 3 years in different companies, and I used to learn new products. So in ATL, as I told you, that I learned these kind of products. But there again, I seen a gap that beyond this network, there are so many things which is called data center services. In data center services, there are three kind of different services like cloud, managed hosting, and this co-location, right? So this is a new thing which I learned. But having said that, there are so many companies which are providing these kind of solution. And here I have seen a gap that if a person is going for this data center services, definitely every organization need that. Every organization, if it is a small organization or a big organization, doesn't matter, right? They have to have data center services in place. But having said that, with data center services, everyone is scared about security, right? This was the eye opener for me, that this is a gap or a vacuum, we can say, where there are very limited people, those who are available within India, those who are aware about the cybersecurity portfolio. Everybody knows about cybersecurity, but nobody knows that what product do what, how they can suffice their requirement, how can they be a valued partner to them. So then again, I started thinking of changing, and I got a chance to work with Tata Communication, because Tata Communication at that point in time, it is currently also the biggest telecom in the world, right? They claim that every third packet which travels on the internet, that is on Tata's backbone. That is that big organization. But having said that, in parallel to that, they are very, very strong player in security also. So that's why, that was the only reason why I joined Tata Communication, just to learn new things. And then again, I started working for that organization and I learned so many things in security. And then after completing my learning of cybersecurity, having a idea about these particular things, I got a chance to work with Radware. And this is where I'm currently working. So this is all about my journey. So why I'm sharing you this particular thing, the main crux is that I was clear from the day one. I'm not saying because I'm speaking to you right now and you are listening to me and only then I'm making this story, that I was clear from day one. It is a hardcore truth that I was very, very clear that I have to work for IT industry, because I always want to be in a white collar job where I will be communicating to the people, those who are actually qualified enough, that yes, they know about technologies, they know about something which not everyone is aware of, right? I want to be a part of those kind of industries. And that's how I was very... This I learned over a period of time, but I was clear that I have to be part of IT industry. Have at least seen this whole path where I want to see in future. Don't run behind each and everything, that yes, you can try for this fashion industry also, you can try for FMCG also, you can try for automotive also, because it will actually not take you anywhere, right? So just be clear on the industry where you want to be. Start studying about that. Start reading newspaper, start reading magazines, right? Think about those things, that what exactly those industries are doing, what are the new things which are coming up, because only then you will make yourself relevant. That is the only suggestion what I can give to you. So that's all about me, that where I have reached, and definitely I'll continue my career in cybersecurity itself. It is a new thing and it is a future thing as well, because nowadays India is not up to the mark that we are actually, we have each and everything in place. And every other day we used to find new vulnerabilities, we used to find new threats which are coming up, right? And definitely we have to provide those solutions to the industries as well. And it is a industry where I can work for next 15-20 years. So this is where I have reached.
Very rightly said, Abrak. And for the students, it is always better to have clarity in your mind that what you want to do. Set a goal for yourself, and then learning, keep learning, is one thing which will keep you ahead of your competitors. Some of these skills which Amrit had throughout his career certainly helped him to reach at the position where he is now. And many of us can take some of the lessons, that what kind of skills are really required how we can update ourselves, how we can keep always an eye on our goal so that we can reach destination. If any one of you, a student, if you have any question, you can ask before we actually move to the next speaker. You can ask question.
Yes, definitely. I will be more than happy to answer.
Yeah.
Because this is what I was keep on doing during my college days, always.
Sir, if you permit, can I ask question?
Ma'am, why
yes,
not?
Ma'am.
You
yes,
have
ma'am.
All the rights.
Amrit, knowing you from your days in the college, there was one particular trait that you had, and that was your, yes, curious mind. However, when you step into the professional world, there are many challenges that you face. Now, could you share with us any such challenge that, you know, simultaneously motivated you and also put you in a fix, and that also kind of changed your entire take on the professional world? You know, sometimes you come across a situation and how you tackle those situations sometimes has a lasting impression on your mind and on your career. And everybody faces that. I know that, you know, you would, since you have been so successful, you would have faced such a certain such situations. Would you like to share those things with your juniors, please?
Sure, ma'am, definitely. Because the biggest challenge, which I, what I have already described, that during my this professional career, right from, if I start from Tulip, so Tulip, then Spectra, then Airtel, then Tata, then Redware, right? Every company having certain set of products. So if I start from Tulip, it was a hardcore telecom company, which is only having this telecom product, which is a network product. And that was a kind of difficult situation, that when you sit with the people or CXO people or the owners of the company, who wants to have data center services also, PRI services also, mobility services also, right? Where we were lacking it. So these kind of challenges we used to face, I used to face in every organization step by step. And this is how actually I covered that. I changed my organization from one organization to other organization. So from Tulip, I faced that, yes, the other telecom products we don't have. So I choose to change the company and I joined Airtel. When I joined Airtel, definitely I covered that, that yes, now with the network piece, we used to cover this mobility piece as well. But having said that, now they were asking for this data center services, cloud services, and security services as well, where Airtel was lacking. Then I again choose to change the company from Airtel to Tata Communication, because this is not something which is in my control. I can't go back to the company management that, yes, this is what customers are looking for, right? And you please develop these kind of skill set. You have to decide that when you are facing these kind of challenges in the industry, then what company is the best for or best fit for their requirements, so that actually you can take care of their customer. Because the key to success in the industry, and especially in our kind of industry, is customers. It is not company which will take you to the next level. It is customer who can take you to the next level. Because today, if I have 50 customers, those who are hardcore customer for me, and they are die-hard fan of me, and definitely I'm working with them closely, they will take me to the next league. Because this is purely visible to my competition also, that Amrit Tyagi is very much connected to these 50 customers, and he can turn around the table for us if he join us. And they will take me to the next league. So we have to work towards customer-centric approach. Definitely, company is giving you everything, but at the same time, company is demanding you something also. Because they are paying you salary, because you are bringing business. But what happens if you don't have the product line? If you don't have such kind of things to place in front of customer, that yes, this is where actually I can fulfill your desires and demands and this care is. So we have to think from that perspective. So this challenge, I think everybody will face when they step out in the commercial world or they step out in their professional world. Because every company is having certain kind of limitation, but then again, it's a learning process. People have to learn new and new things, that yes, this is how actually I overcome it. And they have to focus towards that. And this happens throughout my life. In Tulip, it was certain restriction. In Airtel, again, it was certain other restriction, that beyond this data center services, they don't have anything. Then in Tata Communication, definitely they have this network, they have data center services, they have security services as well. But then they were not very keen towards this, building a new and new things towards cybersecurity. So that was a gap where actually I joined Radware. That is a hardcore security company, and I can actually take care of my customers. So this is how I overcome over a period of time, over the challenges which I faced during the course of life in last 10 years.
Our student can also learn a very good lesson from this. many times, you know, when you grow and company might ask why you have changed this company to this company to this company, actually you can come up with the answer that I have changed for a purpose. I have changed for upgradation. I have changed to complete my knowledge gap. So this certainly will be appreciated rather than looking into as you have changed one company to another company to another company. There's a question in chat box. I think you can see our...
Just a minute, sir.
Yes, sir. There's a question from Harsh Agarwal, actually. So what are the challenges you have while shifting from one company to another company? Because changing company again and again is... Sorry, that's a question from Mr. Paliwal. I'm sorry, sir.
Not an issue. I read that question.
Good in corporate.
Yes. It is not that it is not considered as good. As sir is rightly saying that, yes, changing for a purpose. And if you have a valid reason that why you are keep on changing the companies in every 3 years, if you have a satisfactory answer, everybody will appraise it. Because if I say you that for how long in a corporate world people used to work, mostly 25 years, 30 years, right? How you will be relevant for next 30 years working in the same company? There is no answer to it. Because ultimately, if you keep on doing a monotonous job since morning to evening, the same thing again and again and again, you will not take yourself anywhere. And at the same time, company will also not take themselves anywhere if they are keep on doing the same thing. They also have to evolve over a period of time. If companies are not changing, they are actually not shifting their gears over a period of time with the relevance to the industry, they will also not grow. Same happens with person also. If we don't grow ourselves, if we don't actually keep ourselves updated with the newer and newer things, how we can be relevant in the industry? Because from now, I see that for next 15, 20 years, I have to work for this industry. I have to be in job. Then ultimately, I have to be relevant also. How come it be possible that, think from a perspective that I was still working with Tulip Telecom, although that company is no more. That is only because of that reason that they end up themselves only and only being a telco company. And they got finished. Think from a perspective let me give you a very classical example from this telco companies only. Think about somewhere around 7-8 years back or 10 years back, we can say about, right? How many telco companies were there? Some 14-15 companies, Telenor, Uninor, Aircel, there are so many companies were there, right? Now what is the option available? Why it happened? Because they have not changed their gear. They were not relevant for the market, for the users, for the corporates, for anyone that yes, people should opt for that. So that's why these options are actually becoming limited, because the companies which are currently standing in front of us, which is Reliance Jio, which is Airtel, which is this Vodafone Plus Idea, which is again in a very dicey stage, because I'm really not sure that if they are going to survive for next 1 year or 2 years in India, they want to ramp up their business, right? So we are squeezing on the telco industry and the companies which are surviving because they are shifting their complete gears as per industry demand. So the same way, we also have to keep ourselves updated. And for that particular thing, changing the company is not a bad thing. Everyone will appreciate that if you are changing the things for your own learning, for your personal growth, for your professional growth. There is no harm in that. You have to be very clear that what you are doing and why you are doing. If you have a very correct answer, everyone will appreciate it. Even if you are changing company within 1 year, there is no harm in that.
Right. So Pranav, now you can proceed further so that we can invite Saurabh Singh also to share his views. Yeah.
Right. So rightly said. Sir, that hard work is the essential always. Thank you so much, sir, for this wonderful session.
Thank you very much.
We have learned so many things, and how can we proceed in our upcoming years with hard work and consistency. And I also, being from an IT background, I can understand all the situations, and I'll surely keep all your points in mind and apply them in the upcoming years. Now I would like request our director management ma'am to share some concluding remarks and present the virtual plaque to the guest of honor. Thank you, ma'am.
Saurabh has covered most of the things what is required for students. So there is no scope for my remarks now. So Amrit, it was great listening to you. And I think students must have taken a note out of your experience. It is always better to learn from others' experience. Okay, so that you can improve yourself and be ready for the future challenges.
Yes.
Okay, so it was great. So accept this virtual plaque. This is what definitely we are actually able to connect the world in this cyber time. Okay, if you talk physically, you're talking from which place, Amrit?
I'm currently in Delhi, sir.
In Delhi?
Yes.
Okay. Otherwise, your job location is?
My job location is Delhi, but I used to stay only for 4 to 5 days in India.
Okay.
This is how it
otherwise goes. In SAARC countries?
In SAARC countries, especially then African countries and this Israel and Singapore.
Okay.
So some eight, nine countries I used to visit every week.
Different countries' culture is also a part of, you know, a lot of learning you get out of that.
Yes, absolutely.
You get to know different, places, their infrastructure, their ways, their habits. And I think it is always good to travel.
Yes, absolutely, ma'am. That is, I was very fond of since day one. Moving different places, meeting different people.
Your passion also.
Yes.
Okay. So accept this plaque and definitely we will be mailing you some of the memories of this alumni talk. We will keep this as a treasure, you know. Whenever we spend the time with alumni, it is a great time always.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you,
ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Yes. Thank you so much. Now, moving forward to the second session. So now, today we have among us one of the most eminent and esteemed figurehead, Mr. Saurav Singh Rajput, alumnus of PGDM 2008-10 batch, to share his experience with management students. So he's a versatile actor featured in some of the most popular TV serials and ads of popular brands. Let's watch a small video of his journey from ITS to the Bollywood industry.
Never too late to be what you might have been. Saurav Singh Rajput, an alumnus of ITS Ghaziabad, is a perfect example who turned his career from managing firms to managing his skills. After completing his PGDM from ITS Ghaziabad in 2009, he worked for various renowned brands of the globe like Bose, Nikon, Nerolac and LG. While working for them in the core marketing team at the HO, he had a great time both in terms of learning and delivering impactful results. Bose Corporation needs a special mention, he says, as it awakened his inner self and pushed him to be a little more than what he was. After moving to Mumbai in 2017 for Nerolac and keeping the wish in mind to do something more with himself, he left the corporate world in 2019. Blessed with a baritone voice, for which he got praised by a lot of his friends in and out of the industry, he got some confidence and started training on his voice to become a voice artist. Later, he joined Anupam Kher's Academy for acting and training. Seen already in many TV serials like Kasauti Zindagi Ki, Guddan, Ye Hai Chahate, Choti Sardarni and many more. But the very first impactful opportunity came to him when he got a role in Savdhan India as a negative lead and was highly acclaimed for his realistic performance. He will also be seen in web series Surgical Operations Team by Salman Khan Productions. Further keeping his performance in mind, he had been offered a film on IAF. He also gave voice to various projects including film dubbings, radio ads, promotional videos and many more. His journey is a lesson to those who aspire to do that can be very well explained by the quote of Walt Disney. If you can visualize it, if you can dream it, there is some way to do it. ITS, the education group, wishes luck to Saurav Singh Rajput for his upcoming ventures in life.
So, Pranav, actually, before you invite Saurav Singh, let me invite Professor Durva Roy to say a few words because he has to go somewhere.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. It's always a huge pleasure, especially today when I was watching this film of yours, Saurav. I think I was reminded of your class days, third venture and a third venture. either second bencher or a third bencher, always section B. I feel so proud that you have arrived at your dreams. You've achieved your dream of becoming. It's very different. In the class, he would always say, "Main kuch hatke karna chahta hoon, kuch alag karna chahta hoon." And today, I think he has already proved that. You know, if you have your goal set and your vision in place, you can arrive at your aspiration. And you can become somebody who everybody else looks up to. Similarly, I think even my even our second student, Amrit. Amrit has been a phenomenal student. Wherein, you know, yesterday when I was having a talk, I think Amrit, I mentioned, he was always the most inquisitive person in the class. If there is a logic, he has to question that logic. And you have to make him understand that that logic has a logical, you know, process to it. Unless you can make him understand that, he will never agree to what you say, no matter what you are saying. I had to sometimes even tell, ye book mein mentioned hai, Amrit, so you can go through the book sometimes. But, you know, as Dr. Ma'am rightly mentioned, an albumator is recognized by the deeds and the you know, achievements of their alumni. And both of you today make us so proud of you. And especially because two of you or both of you are from varied fields and look where you are today. For the students today, I think they are huge aspiration. And when you share their stories, when they share their stories, you can really learn a lot of things out of that. So I welcome you to the class and to the college back. And we wish you always the very best in life. I look forward to seeing you rise very steeply and very fast so that, you know, and next time I can go and say, Saurabh, can I have this autograph for my son, please? And Amrit, you know, I can approach you and say.
Ma'am, you got muted.
You are muted, ma'am. Please unmute yourself. Abhi, it's.
Ma'am, you got muted, ma'am.
All right. Yeah. So I hand over the platform to you all now. And I would take your leave, Amrit and Saurabh, because I have to go somewhere. So thank you so much for coming to the campus and coming back to your alma mater.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much.
Yeah, Pranav, you can proceed further.
Yes, sir. So I, Pranav Kumar, on behalf of the PGDM batch 2022, and also on my personal behalf, sir, welcome to you, sir, to this virtual annual session put up by ITS Ghaziabad, sir. Your presence today has delighted us truly. So I would now request you to kindly start the session, and we'll have the few glorious words for you, sir. Thank you. Over to you, sir.
Thank you very much for having me. I don't know. Where should I start from? The first thing I believe where I can, I'm 100% sure that I can start is from Amrit saying that, dude, I really envy you. The kind of work that you are doing, where have you reached? It's really, really motivating. And I'm 100% sure that only 2% or 5% of, you know, every batch's student could reach where you are today. So I envy you. Pray to God that you you know, reach new levels and you know, we'll meet again on certain you know, these kind of platforms and discuss our stories further.
Sure, sir, definitely.
So back to my story. So I don't know where do I start from the corporate thing, from leaving corporate to coming here. It's really tough, but I believe it's better that I pick up from where Amrit left it. You know, asking right questions. So as the ma'am rightly said, see, monologues are not important, dialogues are important. I saw a few questions there down in the chat box, but there are just two or three. So I really want people to ask more questions and ask right questions. That's more important. So picking up from there, I have a story to share. And this story belongs to while I was in college, IBS, asking right questions. So one of Durga ma'am actually gave me this duty to pick up a dignitary from Gurgaon. He was Mr. Rahul Raja Muthaya, who was the COO of the Pantaloons, if I'm not wrong. Yes, I think I'm remembering this correctly. And it was the journey of like good 1.5 or 2 hours, one side. I had a lot of questions in mind. I could have asked him, but before asking those questions, one thing came to my mind. Yaar, ye bande ko log kitne sawal poochte honge? And he was also trying to avoid my questions because he was always on call. And between those calls, whenever I got chance, I thought, what question should I ask? I asked him one question. And that one question was right when we reached from Gurgaon to the gate of ITS. That one question was, sir, what do you think that being a student, I should be doing now so that it is valued tomorrow in corporate? He answered me something. He said, blah, blah, and blah. I'll tell you that later. And he was very happy when he kind of heard that question. He went inside. We were just setting up his laptop. And he started talking to the crowd, everyone, students like us. And he started talking about me. He said, you know, Saurabh was planned to pick me up. And that's how, you know, he asked one question. And it probably was sort of, you know, one wish given to somebody. And he asked the right question. So the thing is, you don't need to have 100 questions. Ask one. But make sure that that question is right there at the right time with the right people. And you have a takeaway out of it. So that's where Amrit Tyagi left. I have certain things or certain experiences of my own journey in corporate to start with. I would pick up from where, again, Durva ma'am left. In school or in colleges or in my PGDM, I always had this thing in mind that, yaar, karna to kuch different hai. And when I say different, it doesn't really mean, you know, at that time, I, of course, didn't have this thing in mind, ki, yaar, I'll become an actor someday. But yes, something better, something what, you know, defines me a little differently than others. It's not about proving that I'm better. No, it's just doing things differently so that people remember me. So college were, I was in last year, colleges were, you know, they were just winding up and everybody was busy in getting a job. I wasn't. I didn't want a job from college. I don't know why, because probably the number of companies that were coming mostly were from you know, getting sales jobs, and people with some experience were getting those jobs and certain things like that. And I just didn't want to do that. I had to do something different. So I went back. I joined my dad's business. Somehow that even couldn't work out, because then I thought this is also very monotonous. And so what I did is, I always had to do a marketing job. So from marketing, what I believe is, you know, defining a corporate strategy. How does a brand operate in market? That's what I really wanted to do. But I wasn't getting a start point. Shuru kahan se kare? I just picked up. So it's again, so the way I look at it as, or the way I define it right now is, when you really want it, it happens. I'm sure this dialogue in Hindi cinema, as everyone has learned it. Jab aap puri shiddat se chahte hain, to kaina bhi aapka saath deti hai. So this happened. I picked up a newspaper. It had a marketing job. It was for not for a company. It was for a dealer payroll job, but for Toyota. So I was getting a brand. I was getting marketing. I went. And it was quite a long ride from Ghaziabad to almost Manesar. I took that ride. I reached there. My application number on day two was 67. So I was one of many, but I got the job because I wanted to. Then I got to know that, you know, marketing jobs, that's not enough. What you need is basically a company payroll job, and that has to be in HO, head office. So I then started looking for it. Again, God's been kind. I got my first opportunity with CAF. Appliances. It's an Italian kitchen appliances company. I was there for 2 years. Starting from like when I joined, the company's turnover was 35 crores. And when I left, it was 215 crores in just 2 years. So if somebody would have asked some, you know, something great about my journey. So I would have said, you know, CAF was one of the best in my lifetime. But again, I was blessed enough to get that thing again and again and again and again until I reached Bose Corporation. So after doing those for 2 years, I again realized that this is an Indian company and every marketing effort is controlled by basically one guy, which is, of course, the managing director and his wife. And there are limitations that you can do things with them. So I moved on. I looked for a job. I was just lucky enough. In next 2 or 3 days, I got a job. I had a letter from Nikon Corporation, the camera company. And I again worked with them for another 2 years, if I'm not wrong. Yeah, 2 years. The opportunity was good. I again did XYZ things. I could remember them. I could tell stories about it. But let's not focus or invest more of our time there. But those 2 years were very engaging. I had to talk to a lot of Japanese people in Singapore. I learned how do these guys are completing their jobs. How can I get into it? Taking jobs which are probably not defined in my KRA, but those are the things which can define myself going forward. So I took all those challenges, and those challenges gave me a lot of experience and confidence. That's more important. So when I again wanted to change because of certain facts that couldn't work between me and Nikon Corporation very well, I went to LG. Even that couldn't last very long because of certain issues that happened between me and the organization. Even the job posting wasn't very well. So then I got to the opportunity of my lifetime, and that lifetime opportunity was to work for Bose Corporation. Why do I call it an opportunity of lifetime? Is because they really gave me something very important, a thing that is still fueling me in my acting career. Yeah, still fueling me in my acting career. And what was that? That was a thing I believe each one of you should have every moment. And that thing is, believe on yourself, that you can do anything that you want. Why do I say this? So when I entered into the organization, that organization was 16 years old here in Indian operation. And that wasn't an profitable organization. When I say profitable, of course, break even cross ho jana chahiye. And all the expenses that you haven't booked in a financial year, which you carry forward, that also has to be, you know, settled in well. So one of the job that, or rather, when we started digging that, why the hell are we not in profit? One of the biggest contributor was our product launches not happening on time. Our stores not operating very well because all the product demos not working very well. And all that stuff which is costing us a lot, and something which is also contributing to it, was the import value of product demo units that we import from China. So the moment I got to know these 2-3 things, I started working on it. And after 3 years, I could, you know, really say that happy moment came to our life. I had to learn mechanical engineering. I had to learn electronic engineering, and I did that. And it's not just me, I believe anybody can do that. Hold on, guys. Yeah, so anybody can do that. The only thing is, do you have the will to do this? And I'm sure everybody has. The only point is, we are just afraid of getting into a position which is, you know, which might turn out into an opportunity, or probably it can also push you to a space which is not very good. People, if you fail, people are always there to push you back and say, you know what, Saurabh did this all wrong. But this is how I am. Nothing really stops me from taking challenges. And I did that. So I learned all that electronic engineering, mechanical engineering, made things in India, make sure all that product launches happens on time. In one financial year, we started saving monies like from 8 to 12 crores in one financial year. And then, you know, it passed on like every year. All the product launches that were happening Earlier, it used to take 60 days in India. We came down that time from 60 days to 13 days. 13. Plus, all the maintenance job that used to happen in stores, wherein all the demos are working, that was also around 90 days. We brought down to in hours in few cases, and the average or the median was 6 days, which is again amazing. But that thing gave me a confidence, or rather something which is very important for everyone, being a student, being me, being anybody on this planet, confidence on yourself. Something that, you know, money can't buy, something that nobody in this world can teach you. It has to be internal. It has to be generated with your own doings. When you do things right, it, falls into right place. You get success, you get confidence. But just make sure that you give chance to yourself to get into that situation. I'm sure bahut sare log yahan pe ye soch rahe honge ki ya hamare actually minds mein ye sab hota hai. Yeah, why do I get into a trouble situation? Why do I take jobs which are not part of my KRA, key responsibility area? Why do I take job which is not mine? Let me just give you an example. In Bose Corporation, I was a marketing guy at HO, doing all the below the line activities, which includes your hoarding spaces at your malls, product launches pan India, product management. Pricing was not a part in India, except that everything related in product management. But people used to call me to change their bulbs in their store. Can you believe that? But I never took this as an offense. I took it as a compliment, saying that this guy has a confidence that no one else in the organization can get this done, but this guy could. I hope I am reaching you the way the sense that I have right now. And those are the things really, helps you excel. For example, like Pranav is trying to, do things, arranging things, coordinating things. And I'm sure tens of you, 20s of you, or all of you must be trying something from your end, making things better for college. Just be a part of that. Do not be afraid of trying new things. Learn from experiences. And how do you learn? By asking right questions. Now, so the corporate thing is over. So after completing around 4 years with Bose Corporation, I realized that all the challenges that someday, aate 4 saal pehle jo mujhe challenges mile the, they all are done. My job was literally, was no job. It was, everything was processed. It was well-oiled machinery. I just have to put, a raw material here, and it used to come out as a finished product from here. And then again, it turned out to be a very boring job. And so I wanted some new avenues to search for. So Nerolac came in, and they had this very wonderful offer, not just in terms of money, but also in terms of areas that I have to take care of. That also includes working with their brand ambassador, and Shah Rukh was one of them at that time, taking care of their all IPL association. So we had 3 teams at that point in time, managing all of that. But after doing with them for 1.5 years, around 2 years with them, I also realized that, after working for Bose, it's very difficult to really cope up with any other organization, because Bose was really a truly multinational company wherein you can really challenge anyone, literally anyone. So if somebody sitting in Boston is not doing their job, you can immediately, right away, even if it is 11 o'clock p.m. for them, you can drop a message and say that, I want to talk to you tomorrow morning. Whatever your time suitable, let me know. Truly international. I not just got to work with people from everywhere on the planet, almost everywhere on the planet, starting from Japan to here, France, but also to understand them. And these guys were not just talking about business, but in general, what happened on Saturday? What happened with your family? I was in certain park last weekend. It was amazing. So the way the culture was given to me in Bose, somehow Nerolac was not able to, meet up with that. And Nerolac's this thing, the passion to work with them was going down, and something else was entering to my life, which is the field of acting, which I am here right now. So I met a few friends over here. They are directors, they are producers, and everybody started appreciating a few things about me. One, the voice that I have is God given. No one really, do anything about it. Right? I really can't. Na main se bada sakta hu, na main se ghata sakta hu. Ye jaisa hai, waisa hi rahega. And second, clarity of words and expressions, which is both in Hindi and English. So here in Mumbai, people don't really have a very good Hindi accent. So they started giving me another belief. So with that, both belief that humans can do anything, at least I can do anything. Just tell me what is most difficult thing that, it's not possible. And I'll just start working towards it. It's not in my mind, it's my modus operandi. That's how my body works. So then I left the job, went to, learning is very important. Nothing in this world can actually replace it. So while you're there in college, make sure that you learn the way no one else could. The moment somebody asks you about BCG metrics, you are damn clear. Anybody asks about any metrics, any definition, you should be 100% clear. Because that's one thing in your absolute control. You cannot have experience. You cannot have anything else. But what you can have is knowledge of your books in your head. So keeping that thing in mind, I went to books. I went to learning acting. I did a small crash course sort of for a month. And then joined some theaters, did some jigs there. And then I started getting some work. Have I achieved anything? I really don't think so. It is only 1% of what my target is. And I'm really looking forward to do more there. While I am towards closing off for whatever I had to say, I hope even my time should be, my time is also done. I really look forward to ask a few questions if you guys have. So please feel free, ask questions, ask right questions. Don't ask a question just because you have to ask a question. I'm sure every batch has two or three such people like that who always have questions, but they cannot retain answer. And that's very bad. That's really, it's not going to help you. See, not asking question is a problem. I have always asked question. Right question at the right time. Always put 100% to whatever you do. Whatever. Even if you are putting, water to your plant, do it the way no one else in this world could do. And trust me, you will get your dream. And please have faith on your dreams. If you think that you can get to that brand, that position, you will do it. The only thing is you have to look for a path. Ki ye pahunchna kaise? Do I have to crack an interview? And for interview, do I need to learn good English? Do I need to be expressive? Do I need to look better? Do that. Just make target and look for path. Kuch logon ka idhar se jayega, kuch ka niche se, kuch upar se, do whatever. But just keep that. Wo zid hona bahut zaruri hai. And then trust me, it's all nature and it's listening to you. It is listening to you. I'm all done.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thanks.
Guys, if you have any questions, you can ask me. I actually have one question for you, sir. So being a management student, today it is very difficult to get jobs and all. So how did you manage to pursue your dream and follow your passion going into the...
I'll tell you. See, the power of your thought is very important. And you need to understand it very well. If you repeat this thing 20 times a day that getting a job is difficult, it is going to be difficult. Trust me. What are you looking for? One job position. There are how many companies in India? 1,000? 10,000? Probably a lakh. You're looking for one position. Now tell me, how difficult is it? Have faith on your dreams. Think मुझे वहां जाना है, मैं पहुंच जाऊंगा. प्रोबेबली अगेन आई हैव टू लुक फॉर पाथ. इट कैन बी डिफिकल्ट, इजी और वट एवर. टिल यू आर देयर इन कॉलेज, मेक श्योर दैट यू लर्न नाइसली. This might include some soft skill. This might include Excel skill. This might include Excel में pivot लगाना and VLOOKUP सीखना and all that skill. But keep adding skills to yourself. If you start respecting yourself, then only others will start respecting you and give you that job or respect or responsibility, anything for that matter. And I need to be very honest about this. I never used to talk like this. In colleges, I just don't remember that even a single word used to come out of my mouth in English. In graduation, of course, the situation for PGTM was a little different. But that's how, first is find out your strengths and weaknesses. Work towards it. Work towards your strength as well and your weakness. Do not hide. Make it in a way that, you know, if this is my weakness, let me make it two. Let me work towards this and not that. So I cannot speak English. Let it be. Go to auditorium and start talking to an empty auditorium. Can you do that? That's easy. Can't it be? There is always a way. And you know the way. Each one of us does. It's there in our head. I hope few of us has heard this word called Atmachintan. What is it? It's always there in our head. It's always, God is nowhere. It's inside us. It gives us answer. It's who needs to listen to it.